Today we are learning about EEPROM, or Electrically Erasable Programmable Read-Only Memory. Well, I think we are going to stick to EEPROM. So what is EEPROM? EEPROM was created by Intel in 1978, and it is a non-volatile type of memory, which means it doesn't need power to retain data. Other types of non-volatile memory include SD cards, flash drives, and hard disks. On the other hand, volatile memory, also known as RAM, needs power to retain data. Microcontrollers such as the Arduino use non-volatile memory to store data permanently, for example the actual program of the Arduino, and volatile memory to store temporary variables. But why do we even use volatile memory and not only rely on non-volatile memory? To answer that question, we need to understand the limitations of non-volatile memory. First, it has a limited number of rewrites, which means that you can only change its value for a certain number of times. EEPROM can typically support between 100,000 and 2 million rewrites. And considering that an Arduino can do more than 16 million operations every second, it would take no time to reach this limit. This is why you need to be very careful with how often you rewrite your EEPROM. Another limitation of EEPROM is that it can retain data for about 10 years at room temperature. And I guess this limitation is not really an issue for most of our projects. Well, of course, unless you are Elon Musk and you are working on an intergalactic mission. So now, let's see how to use EEPROM on an Arduino. First, you need to know that there are two types of EEPROM for Arduino. There's the internal EEPROM, which comes built-in in the Arduino, and the external EEPROM, which is a separate module that you can buy. The main differences are that the external EEPROM has a larger size and thus can store more data, and also usually supports a larger number of rewrites. Now, in order to use the internal EEPROM, you simply need the Arduino EEPROM library and three simple functions. EEPROM read, write, and clear. And as the name suggests, you can read data from the EEPROM, write data to the EEPROM, and clear all the data on the EEPROM. Although EEPROM write works, I would recommend to use EEPROM update, because this method reads the EEPROM value first, and then only updates it if it is different. And this will minimize the number of rewrites and extend the life of the EEPROM. Now, in order to use the external EEPROM, you will need to connect it to your Arduino using an I2C bus. I2C is a method of serial communication between many devices using only two wires, also known as the bus. To program the Arduino with an external EEPROM, you can't directly use the Arduino EEPROM library. Instead, you need to create your own read, write, and update functions using the I2C library. Those functions need to send the byte address to the EEPROM and transfer the data between the EEPROM and the Arduino. To save you time, I already created those functions for you, and you can download them using the link in the description below. In the next episode, we will see how we can use EEPROM to transform a simple Arduino project into a complete standalone product. And you are going to test it on last week's project, where we learned how to control an Arduino using the Apple HomeKit. In the meantime, you should watch one of the videos on the screen right now and leave a like if you found the video useful. And I will see you next week.